Hello student. So after completion of the kidney, we should have to start the next part of the urinary system, that is the ureter. So the ureter, it is the narrow, thick-walled, muscular tube or the tubular structure which convey the urine from kidney to the urinary bladder. So that is the only one function, that is it carry the from urine which is into the kidney, it should be passes into the urinary bladder. Okay, then it location, it is lie in the deep to the peritoneum, closely applied to the posterior abdominal wall in the upper part and the lateral pelvic wall in the lower part. So the as we called, it is the tubular part. So the length, according to its length, some half part means upper part of that is the ureter, that should be present into the abdomen, and the lower part of the ureter, that should be present into the pelvis. ठीक है, after then we should have to see, that is the measurement which includes the length, then the thickness, then the lumen of the ureter. So now we should have to see this structure. So here in this diagram you can see, that is the ureter which starts from the renal sinuses. So here this is the renal sinus part, it should be comes out from the kidney and goes downwards and then enters into that the urinary bladder. Okay, then the measurement or the length. So length of the urine, so length of the ureter, that is from the renal sinus to that the urinary bladder, that is 25 cm, means or the 10 inches. Then out of this, the part of the ureter which is present into the during its length, that is as the length of the ureter is 25 cm, so that is the total part of the ureter that is not present into that the abdomen, the upper half part that should be present into that the abdomen, and the lower one part, lower part of the ureter that should be present into that the pelvis. So in the another diagram you can see here, this is the ureter, green color part, this one to this one, and this is the urinary bladder. Okay, so these vertical fibers you can see, that is these fibers, they are the posterior abdominal wall, and this posterior abdominal wall, it is made by the 4 muscles, that is these vertical fibers you can see, these fibers are of the psoas major muscle and the psoas minor muscle, and the transversely fibers you can see on the both side, that is the transverse abdominis, and the other muscle which is present into that the pelvis, that is called the iliacus. So these 4 muscles, it should be forming the posterior abdominal wall. So posterior abdominal wall, the upper part of the ureter, it should be present into the posterior abdominal wall, and the remaining part here, this lower part of the ureter which is present into that the pelvis. Okay, so half inch part, they we have to see, that is the total length is 10 inches. So out of this 5 inch part which is present into the abdomen, that is called the abdominal part of the ureter, and the 5 inches part which is present into that the pelvis, so that is called the pelvic part of the ureter. Okay, then now we have to see, that is the course of the ureter. So the ureter, it should be starts from the renal sinus. So renal sinus, it is the part of the kidney from which, that is the renal artery, the renal vein and the renal pelvis, it should be comes out. So it should be starts from, that is the renal sinus, where it should be formed that the dilated part. So here in the upper part of the ureter you can see that the dilated part, it is called the renal pelvis. Then it goes downwards direction and at the level of the lower pole of the kidney on both side. Here you can see in the lower pole of the kidney that it should be from the narrow part. So from the narrow part of the ureter, it is actually this part, it is called the ureter, and upper part which is dilated part, this one and this one, it is called the renal pelvis. Okay, then this part, it goes downward direction and at the bifurcation of the common iliac artery. So here you can see, that is the abdominal aorta and this is the common iliac artery, this is the right common iliac and this is the left common iliac, and at this point the common iliac artery, it should be divided into the internal iliac artery and that is the external iliac artery. So at the bifurcation of the common iliac artery, this ureter, it should be crosses, and from this point it should be enter into that the pelvis. ठीक है, एंड देन इट गोज डाउनवर्ड्स एंड देन एंटर्स इनटू दैट द यूरिनरी ब्लैडर एट द अपर एंड द पोस्टीरियर सरफेस ऑफ द यूरिनरी ब्लैडर. ठीक है, नाउ वी हैव टू सी दैट इज द हिस्टोलॉजी ऑन द इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द यूरेटर. ठीक है, सो यूरेटर इट शुड बी मेड बाय द थ्री लेयर्स एंड फ्रॉम इनर टू आउटर साइड इट शुड बी फॉर्म द इनर मोस्ट लेयर विच इज द म्यूकस मेम्ब्रेन विच इज मेड बाय द ट्रांजिशनल एपिथेलियल सेल्स. देन द सेकंड लेयर इट इज कॉल्ड द स्मूथ मस्कुलर लेयर एज इट इज द मस्कुलर ऑर्गन. शुरू में इन द स्टार्ट वी हैड कॉल्ड इट इज द मस्कुलर ट्यूबुलर ऑर्गन. सो इट द सेकंड लेयर दैट इज मेड बाय द स्मूथ मस्कुलर लेयर एंड इट इज मेड बाय द थ्री लेयर that is inner side in upper two-third part of the ureter. It is made by the longitudinal muscular coat and the outer circular coat. Means inner side it should be from the longitudinal muscular coat and outer side it should be from the inner circular coat. That should be present into the upper two-third part of the ureter. And in lower one-third part, it is consist of the inner longitudinal layer, outer circular layer and outermost that is the longitudinal layer. Means it should be formed by the three layers. Upper two-third part it is made by only the two layer that is the inner longitudinal and outer circular, and lower one-third part it is made by the three layer that is inner longitudinal, middle circular and the outer longitudinal layer. ठीक है, then then the outer layer of the ureter it is made or it is called the tunica adventitia. So outermost layer that is called the tunica adventitia and it is made by the connective tissue. ठीक है, then after then we have to see that is the narrowing of that the ureter. ठीक है, so as we called that is the lumen of that is the ureter that is the 3 mm. ठीक है, ड्यूरिंग द इट्स लेंथ दैट इज वी हैव सीन द लेंथ ऑफ द यूरेटर दैट इज द 25 सेंटीमीटर और द 10 इंचेस एंड द लुमेन ऑफ दैट द यूरेटर दैट इज द कॉमनली यूमेन दैट इज 3 mm. ठीक है, बट इट इज नॉट यूनिफॉर्म इन ऑल डायरेक्शन ऑफ दैट द यूरेटर. सो हियर इन द अपर पार्ट यू कैन सी दैट शोज द डायलिटेशन एंड इन सम रीजन इट शुड बी फॉर्म सम नैरोइंग पार्ट. ठीक है, एंड क्लिनिकली दिस सम नैरोइंग पार्ट दैट इज वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज दैट इज द रीनल कैलकुलस और द किडनी स्टोन दे शुड बी लॉजेस इनटू दैट द नैरोइंग पार्ट ऑफ द यूरेटर. सो फॉर दिस अगेन वी शुड हैव टू सी दैट इज द अनदर डायग्राम. सो हियर यू कैन सी दैट इज द नैरोइंग पार्ट ऑफ द यूरेटर. सो फर्स्ट नैरोइंग पार्ट here that is the pelvi-uretric junction. So pelvi-uretric junction that is the junction of the renal pelvis and actually that is the lower pole of the kidney where that is the actually the ureter should be start. So in this part that is it should be shows that is the first constriction. ठीक है, then the second here that is the pelvic brim means from where that is the ureter that should be enters into that the pelvis. So this region that is called the pelvic brim and in this region it shows again shows that is the constriction. ठीक है, then the next the ureter where it crosses the vas deferens. Here you can see in the male that is the vas deferens and in the female it should be crosses the broad ligament of the uterus. So in this region it should also shows that is the constriction. Then the next fourth where the ureter it should be enters into that the urinary bladder. So here in this region it shows that is the small constriction. ठीक है, and last one constriction here you can see that is the trigony or the lateral angle of the urinary bladder where actually that is the opening of ureter that should be occurs into that the urinary bladder. ठीक है, so here in the 5 regions it should be shows that is the small constriction and clinically this part is very much important because the renal calculus or the renal stone it should be lodges or blocks the pathway of passing of the urine from kidney to that the ureter. ठीक है, after then we should have to see that is the blood supply of the ureter. So for this we should have to see the another diagram and the blood supply as the length of the ureter is 25 cm. So the ureter it is supplied by the different arteries. So in this diagram you can see that is the blood supply of the ureter. So firstly, in the upper part, that is here you can see, that is the ureter, this one, and in the upper part of the ureter, this one, it is supplied by the branch of the renal artery. On both sides you can see, this is the renal artery and branch is coming out the renal artery, which is supplied to that the ureter. Okay? Then in the middle part of the ureter, this one, that is supplied by the branch of here, that is the abdominal aorta. So this is the abdominal aorta and the branches come out, that is the gonadal artery, and from this branch is supplied to the middle part of the ureter, that is the directly branch from the abdominal aorta. And the lowermost part, which is present into that the pelvis, it is supplied by the vesical artery, the middle rectal artery, or the uterine artery. So that is the directly branch from the common iliac artery and the internal iliac artery. So these three parts of the ureter, that is supplied by the different arteries. Okay? Then the venous drainage. The venous drainage, that is, comes out the capillary plexus from the interlobular veins, which run along the corresponding arteries. Okay? So it should be forming that the corresponding vein and forming that the plexus. Okay? Then the lymphatic drainage, the lymphatics from the kidney drain into the lateral aortic lymph nodes. Okay? So same like the kidney, there the lymphatic drainage that should be occurs. And the nerve supply, that is, as it is the constriction organ or contractile organ, so that is supplied by the sympathetic nerve and the parasympathetic nerve. The sympathetic nerve, that is related with the constriction and related with the pain, and the parasympathetic nerve, that is related with the relaxation of the ureter. So the sympathetic nerve supply, that is from the T10 to L1 spinal nerve. And the parasympathetic nerve supply, that is from S2, S3 and S4 spinal nerve. Okay? Then after then we should have to see, that is the clinical points related with that the ureter. So first clinical point which is related with the ureter, that is the renal colic. So here in this diagram, that is, we know that is the kidney, that is very commonly resemblance for the renal calculus or the renal stone. And if that the small renal stone with the urine, it should be comes into the ureter and it should be block that the passage of the ureter. And because of the blockage, it should be form the contraction of the ureter or the spasm of the ureter, and this spasm, it should be occurs the severe abdominal pain, that is called the renal colic. Okay? Then the second part, that is the ureteric calculus or the ureteric stone. So very commonly you can see, that is the constrictile part of, that is the ureter, this is the pelvi-ureteric junction, that is the pelvic brim and the utero-vesical junction, that is the three places the constriction of, that is the ureter, that should be occurs. And whenever that is the kidney stone, it comes into this region, and as it is large than the 3 mm, so it should be blockage the pathway of the passing of urine. Okay? So that is the ureteric stone. Then third one, so whenever you want to see the ureter because of any type of pathology, so you should done the plain radiograph of the skiagram, or that is called the plain radiograph of X-ray. Okay? This should be seen in the transverse process of lower 4 lumbar vertebra. So if any stone is present, and stone is made by the calcium mostly, that is the transopaque structure, and that can be seen or trapped by the X-rays. So during the plain radiograph or the plain X-ray, that is the renal calculus or the renal stone, that should be seen into that the ureter. Okay? And that is very commonly seen into the lower 4 transverse process of lower 4 lumbar vertebra. Okay? So these are the clinical points related with the ureter. See? Next lecture we should have to see, that is the anatomy of urinary bladder.